This drive is set up to have forward and reverse controlled by an external switch and a drive speed controlled by the HMI in remote mode. Let's see how to do that. First, let's reset the drive to factory default so we're starting in the exact same place. I went ahead and set my parameters for my motor, yours will probably be different, and I also shortened the ramp times to help expedite the video. That won't be a problem here because I don't have a load on this motor. My computer is connected to the drive via this optional USB module, and I'll be using the free WPS software to set this up because it's easier for you to see what I'm doing. You can do everything we'll do here from the drive's HMI, so you really don't have to purchase a USB module or use the free WPS software to do this. And just to be clear, when I say HMI in this video, I'm talking about the drive's built-in HMI keypad, this guy. I'm using the HMI terminology because that's what it's called in the manual and in the WPS software. I just want to be sure you understand I'm not talking about an AutomationDirect CMOR or CMOR Micro HMI. We'll do that in a different video. I've already set up a configuration and a resource, and I'm connected to the drive. Let's bring up the parameter list. We want to be in remote mode, so let's search for remote, and we see the remote local selection is parameter 220, and it defaults to local. So let's change that to remote. I have this selector switch set up as a forward stop reverse switch and connected to the drive like this using the switch's normally open contacts. So we need to tell the drive that digital input 1 is forward and digital input 2 is reverse. So I'll search on DI, and we see DI1 defaults to run stop. So we'll change that to forward. And DI2 defaults to direction, so we'll change that to reverse. Great. Now we just need to make sure the remote speed control is via the HMI. So I'll search on remote, and we see that the reference speed is currently being driven by the analog input. Let's change that to the HMI. We're done. Let's try it. Sure enough, I can control the forward and reverse directions of the motor, and the HMI controls the speed of the motor in remote mode. Perfect. Could I do this with the switch doing a simple run stop? Sure. Just change DI1 to run stop and DI2 to direction and wire the two switches like this. Now this switch controls the run stop and this switch controls the direction. Notice that the direction switch only changes the HMI rotation indicator when the drive is running. If the drive isn't running, the indicator doesn't change. One side note, if we search on remote, we see in remote mode, run stop defaults to being controlled by the digital inputs, so we didn't need to change that. But you should verify that it set the digital inputs anyway just to make sure someone else didn't change it. In contrast, if we search on local, we see its run stop defaults to HMI control, so just beware they are different. Here's a summary of the parameters we used to do this. Since we really only changed 4 parameters, this would be easy to do from the drive's HMI. I prefer to use the WPS software because it's so easy to search for and change the parameters I need. Click here to learn more about the WEG CFW300 variable frequency drive. Click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free award-winning support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.